although there are more and more people saying that the U.S. economy will be in a recession next year.
A lot of schools are being forced to cut back on theater and arts programs for students. And the U.S. Department of Education says students involved in instrumental music during middle and high school years show significantly higher levels of math proficiency by the 12th grade.
Million miles away, you're signaling the distance to whom it may concern. I think I lost my way, getting good at starting over every time.
Because I was involved in music, it gave me a sense of confidence and purpose. It gave me structure. It allowed me to do something that I really loved. And it was very helpful because it helped me organize materials, time, everything basically, so that I was a good student, because I knew what it took to start a project and continue to work until that project was completed and then start another project. And so there was a sense of growth and purpose in my music education from the very beginning through high school, and then I went on to Western, where I earned my bachelor's degree in music education and then my master's degree in music. And you can't learn all the things that you can learn if you do music.
Music has affected my life by allowing me to like work harder in school, and it helps build discipline. So when you want to get things done, it'll like help you be motivated to get those things done, and it just helps build that throughout your life. And another thing it does is it like allows you to meet new people when you go to concerts or competitions or just band festivals where there are other kids and you can like mingle and meet new people, make new friends.
Also, it has socially affected me, which I've met lots of people and made lots of friends, and they're all really nice quality people.
I started taking cello and fifth grade strings in the Ferndale School District, and that was a really positive experience for me. It was an extra challenge for me at that point. I found music easy, so fifth grade strings was an extra challenge and gave me something to focus on, and I started private lessons the following year in sixth grade and kept it up through middle and high school, obviously, and found that it gave me a great group of friends to be with and a lot of exciting experiences working with famous musicians and really excellent performing groups that challenged my, my playing and my technique, and forced me to be a leader in the orchestra. I was orchestra president my senior year. I was responsible for gigs and getting to places, learning lots of different music, playing in a lot of different groups, and it really challenged me and made me responsible. So I find that's the case with my students now, that those extra opportunities in music really help them achieve really great things.
Okay, so music has been a huge part of my life overall. Like last year, I did my protest project on the benefits of music to an entire society, which Mr. Knote, you remember, there's that, And also, I'm planning on going into music for a career. It's something I truly love, and without it, I wouldn't have a place to get all my stress out, because I do a lot of stuff and I don't have a whole lot of time to screw around. But my time with music allows me to just put all of my angst, anger, all those horrible bad words that I'm not going to continue to list off because I can't think of them. All of those ones I put into music, and it can make it sound better depending on setting, and it's just a good vent, a good way to let anything out. I'm not a huge one for social interaction. You could call me a nerd, but my time at band has let me hang out with people who are really fun, and I know them really well. Like, it's another family for me, because at home, it's been kind of rough recently with all of not goodness going on. So it's been nice to have a net of people here whenever you need them. It's just a good group. Even in other settings such as orchestra and choir, I haven't been in them much, but it's the same thing. Just the medium in which music is made is different.
So, hello there. My name is Mr. Carnegie. I teach band here at Bellingham High School. I don't know if you need to know that or not. Music was a big part of my life. That's part of why I'm here, actually, as a music teacher. I think it's fair to say that a lot of my social interactions with people, middle school and high school and beyond, revolved around my experience with music. Some of my best friends were part of the music program at my high school. They were folks that I would see in class on a day-to-day basis and at performances, and also would get to go on various trips with and go to competitions and festivals and marching parades. And that tight group of friends was kind of my social circle at many times throughout high school and into college as well. Academically, music was a very motivating factor for me. Getting to participate in festivals and touring and competitions and those sorts of things was kind of a carrot for me. It was something that was exciting and I wanted to do. And if I was struggling in other courses, wasn't always allowed to participate in those sorts of events, or at least that was school policy. So in some cases, it was a way of encouraging students to do better in other places. But beyond that, I think there's a lot of research that suggests a connection between the study of art, or you could say music specifically, and success in other realms as well. There's been studies that have shown musicians, while engaged in producing music, and actually images of the brain and brain activity and seeing both hemispheres lighting up like a Christmas tree, and seeing a connection between left and right hemisphere and all over the place, all these different skills that come together in order to perform.
Prices will happen.
The biggest fiscal stimulus we have ever seen.
And that'll solve the problem.
We are in the midst of a serious financial crisis. And the federal government is responding with decisive action.
You also wanted me to talk a little bit about budget cuts and how they've affected our programs. One of the biggest problems that we've seen, or that I have seen, is that we do not have middle school choir at every middle school for 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. Our students are coming in with very little knowledge at ninth grade level, and we're having to make up and teach them everything that they would have learned if they had been in the middle school choir program or a middle school choir program. So we work really hard at the high school level, but because we don't have kids that come in and know a lot of high school students choose not to participate because they think they're not going to be able to do it or do it very well. And I always try to tell students it's their job to just try to get better at singing, and it's my job to make sure that they do.
Budget cuts have been an issue to music and always have been an issue for music, and particularly now they're problematic. The biggest cut for strings is the cut of fifth grade strings. 2 years ago our fifth grade strings program was cut. That hasn't affected us yet, but it will starting in 2 years when that group of ninth graders coming in will have had one less year of playing. It also affects the bands too, because band traditionally is pulled from the fifth grade strings pool. So the quality of the middle school band and the high school band will go down a little bit as well, because some of those students will have had a year less of instrumental music in elementary school. And it's just, again, a loss of opportunities for kids to excel and to do well, which is really important in school. Otherwise, there haven't been significant cuts to the high school orchestra program yet, and we're hoping that there won't be.
Money has been a big thing, and it's not a new thing. Budget cuts have been an issue since before I was in the teaching business. But it's a big topic these days, and you can hear anybody anywhere talking about money in some shape or form. And it's no different in the academic education world. Budget cuts are something that we all get to look forward to as teachers, and different ways that communities and school districts have to find ways to make do with less. That's just the growing reality of education in America. Some places that I've been experiencing budget cuts recently. Here at Bellingham High School, we've adjusted our course offerings. We used to have two ensembles that we would offer to WIN students, and this year we're offering basically one and a half. In the fall, we have a combined concert band, which is all the WIN students combined into one class. And then in the spring, we get to split into our traditional WIN ensemble audition group and symphonic band. There's been some challenges that have come up with that, obviously, by taking an entire population of students that are working at often different levels, one group being a more experienced audition group, one group being more of an introductory group to the music program, and combining all that together and only offering one course has been a little challenging at times, to not be able to really meet the needs of everyone at the same time. Additionally, at the middle school, I currently teach at Whatcom Middle School, we've been running into a similar issue, really on a larger scale. Traditionally, at a middle school program, you might have three bands, one for each grade, kind of a beginning sixth grade band, intermediate seventh grade band, and an eighth grade band with students that have been in the band program for a few years. This year at that particular middle school, we have one combined band. It's 40 kids. 6th through 8th grade, there's students that are brand new. The bulk of the students are brand new to music, so in a sense it is a beginning band. But we also have students that are very active and have been playing their instruments for 2, 3, 4, 5 years. And it's been a challenge for some of those kids to be part of the same group and to feel like they're being challenged and developing and growing as musicians while playing hot cross buns with the 6th graders and the other new students. So it's a very real issue we get to look forward to as educators and students in programs, and trying to be creative to find ways to make it work for everybody.